السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله والشكر لله that we came and prayed صلاة الصبح. نسأل الله to accept our صلاة and to add it to our lots of حسنات إن شاء الله في يوم القيامة بإذن الله. وندعوه أن to keep us under his own provision and protection for today and for every other day. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم ارحمنا، اللهم ارزقنا، اللهم اهدنا لما تحبه وترضاه. فمن يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أما بعد، we'll continue talking about Ghazwat Uhud, and we see that in the beginning the Muslims were really victorious. Everything was fine, and Jaish Abu Sufyan started to run away and escape and withdraw, and chaos in the army of Mushrikeen. But because there are some people didn't listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? They broke their oath, broke their promise to him. They didn't listen to what he told them several times and assured it. The situation changed upside down. And now the Muslim army is in deep trouble. Okay? And the target of the Quraysh Mushrikeen is to kill Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the breaking the promise could have led to killing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam unless Allah is keeping Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's ma'asum from al-qatl. He's not being killed. Could Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep Muslims always victorious all the time? Yes, of course you could make them all victorious, right? But Allah is teaching us, Allah is yabtaleen, Allah is showing us an example that whenever you guys don't listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's gonna happen to you. Okay, now the army of the Muslims now are in deep trouble. Okay, everybody is trying to come and kill Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم had like some people around him, 9 people around him to protect him. The rest of the army started fled away and started running away and withdraw, and you know, and we saw that 9 people around رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم to protect him. They were all killed except the 2 people. طلحة ابن عبيد الله وسعد ابن أبي وقاص. Among the 9 who are really were protecting رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. They were around him fighting bravely, just sacrificing their bodies, sacrificing themselves in order to keep رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم alive. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by himself, he was also standing and fighting and protecting himself. Okay? And there was a lady, very nice lady, sahabiya. Her name is Nasiba Amara. Nasiba Amara. Okay? Nasiba Amara, actually, she participated in the army just to give water to the soldiers, to the fighters. Okay? To damage jirah, just to cure the injuries of the injured people, you know, that's the woman task. But when she saw that everybody is really متكالبين على رسول الله at رسول الله, she threw everything she had and she took her sword and start protecting رسول الله around him. Fighting anybody coming to Rasulullah to kill him. She was fighting better than, you know, those people who ran away, okay? And Rasulullah also was also fighting with him, you know, she kept fighting until she was really hurt. You know, she was injured about 10, 12, you know, injuries in her body. Okay? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says afterwards, he said, ما التفت يمينا ولا شمالا يوم أحد إلا ورأيتها تقاتل دوني. He said, I never looked during the battle, I never looked to the right or to the left, and I don't see her. She's always there around me. So that she is really brave, brave woman. Then one guy, son of a gun, okay, his name is Abdullah ibn Qami'a. He came in. Wicked guy from Quraysh. Yeah. Okay. He came in and trying to kill Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who stood against him? Nasiba Umma Umar. Start fighting him. Okay. But he was, of course, he overwhelmed him. Okay. He hit her with his sword. He dislocated her shoulder. Okay. And you know, he won her. Okay. She didn't die. She lived later on, and she was actually part of the people who killed Musaylam al-Kathab, Nasiba. So we have remembered that lady, Nasiba Umm Amara. Okay. So what's her name? The name of her son? Amara, right? Nasiba Umm Amara. Yeah, I want you guys to wake up. Come on. Okay. Anyway, don't be sleepy like me. Anyway. During that chaos, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was defending himself also, he fell into a ditch, Hufra. Okay? And kusirat ruba'iyatu. Her front teeth were broken. What are the ruba'iyah? Ruba'iyah, those are, you know, the two canines. You have two canines up and two canines down. Okay? And the teeth between them, those are the ruba'iyah. Okay, they're broken. Okay, when he fell down. And who also broke it, okay, that actually the brother of Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas. Sa'd ibn Waqqas, great man, and his brother was stupid man, okay? Utba ibn Abi Waqqas. Utba ibn Waqqas actually broke also Ruba'iyat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasulullah, see the damage now is going to happen to Rasulullah because not listening to him. Not listening. Kusrat Ruba'iyatu. Her lips were injured. Blood was everywhere on his face. Okay. And his forehead also. Being injured, being hit, and blood was also falling on his face. And Abdullah ibn Qami'a, he's really Qami'a guy, okay? Abdullah ibn Qami'a, ism ala musamma, Qami'a, يعني hatred, ugly, you know, Qami'a, okay? Qami'a, the word Qami'a really describes him, okay? And he came and he hit Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his cheek here. You know, people were during the war, they're wearing like a helmet, okay, and it has two sides in here, metal, to protect your cheek. So he hit this one, so those two metal just got into punctured the cheeks of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh, blood, you know, never stopped, you know. Anyway. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So they call it الحلقتين من المغفر. That one is called المغفر. Those حلقتين just went into punctured the cheeks of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول الصحابة كانت قريش تنهال عن الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. الصحابة is describing that later. He said, arrows was coming to Rasulullah from right and left, from front and from the back, everywhere, just all, he's the focus, all the arrows coming to him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him. Okay? Anyway. Then remember our brave guy Abu Dujana. He came in. He came in, okay? And he saw Nasiba still fighting, you know, still fighting around Rasulullah, fighting, protecting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Rasul is also protecting himself. So he came in and he lost his shield, okay, but he has the sword. You remember the sword Rasulullah gave it to him and he said, "Atiya haqqa," and he came with looking for Rasulullah, "Ya Rasulullah," and he showed him the sword. "This is the sword you gave it to me. Hal qad waffaytahu haqqa? Did I do exactly what you asked me to do?" It was bent. Mm-hmm. Rasulullah told him, "You just fight with it until it bent." So should, yes, so Rasulullah told him, "Yes, Abu Dujana, qad waffaytahu." And then he said, "Is there any shield? I lost my shield. Okay, is there any shield you can protect Rasulullah? Is there any tears we can protect Rasulullah? Looking for something to protect Rasulullah." So Rasulullah said, "There is no shield." He said, "Okay, I am your shield, Ya Rasulullah. I am your shield." Then he embraced him, okay, ihtadanu, okay, and he said, "My back will be your shield, Ya Rasulullah." He kept on embracing him, you know, and all the arrows were coming to Abu Dujana in the back and the right, okay, and you say, "Abi anta wa ummi ya Rasulullah, I will never see you bleeding as long as I have one eye still blinking." Okay? "La araka tanzif wa fiya aynun tatruf." And he kept on holding Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, giving his back to the mushrikeen, and the mushrikeen was just, that was the target for them. People saying afterwards, okay, because of the whole bunch of arrows came in every time, he says, and he's, you know, is yata'allam, okay? And Rasulullah, and he says to Rasulullah, "Ma atyabuha fi sabilika ya Rasulullah." See how the love for the people for Rasulullah, sacrificing themselves. This is the iman, this is the iman. You remember when Rasulullah was talking to Umar ibn al-Khattab and told him, "You love me more than yourself," and finally said, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah, I love you, I sacrifice myself for you." So that's one example of them. People describing now the situation of Abu Dujana and how he looks like, he said, because of the so many arrows in the back, he looks like a porcupine, confused. Okay, everything is coming out of him, you know, porcupine. Anyway, he didn't die. He lived and he participated in the war against those people who reverted during Abu Bakr Siddiq, Harb al-Ridda, later on, okay? Then he fainted, okay? He couldn't do anything afterwards. Then Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas came in, okay? He failed. Now, still, we need somebody to protect Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas came in. He said, "Is there any shield we can protect Rasulullah?" He said, "No." Okay. Sa'd ibn Waqqas was known to be a very good thrower of bow and arrow. He's really very good. Okay. So he said, "Ya Rasulullah, okay, I lost my bow during Amta. Is there any bow here I can use it with my arrows? I still have arrows, but I don't have the bow." He said, "Well, I just take my bow." Rasulullah gave him my bow. Okay. So he took it and he said, "Ya Rasulullah, it's all broken and all the thread in it, you know, the thing, you know, the wire in it is broken." So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Just take it and say Bismillah." So he said Bismillah and start pulling the thread. He said, the thread became fine and he made a loop around it and he fixed it up. Wow. And he started throwing the, you know, his arrows, you know, to the, he almost threw about 1,000 arrows at that time. He finished all the arrows he had. Rasulullah gave him some of his arrows. And the people saw him bringing some arrows to me. Irmiya Sa'ad. He threw about 1,000 arrows at that time. Then came طلحة ابن عبيد الله. I'm finishing with this one. Came طلحة ابن عبيد الله. You remember طلحة ابن عبيد الله؟ طلحة ابن عبيد الله. You remember him? During the migration of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he and Abu Bakr to Medina, to Yathrib at that time, he met them. He was a merchant coming from al-Sham and he had lots of merchandise and he met them. Okay? And of course he knew them, he saluted them and everything, and he gave them new clothes, white clothes at that time, to go into Yathrib with new fresh clothes, you know. No traces of traveling and, you know, beautiful clothes. So Talha ibn Ubaidillah, at that time he was about 28 years old, okay? Shabab, huh? They are all young, yes, they are all young, okay? And he started defending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was injured about 30 something injury, 39, 37, whatever they say, something like that. Okay, just keep on protecting him. And one time was an arrow coming to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He stood by his hand. He received it by his hand. So the arrow came to his hand. What happened to his hand? Paralyzed. His hand paralyzed. And so he fell down. Okay, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he says later on, Abu Bakr says, إِذَا ذُكِرَ يَوْمُ أُحُدْ أَمَامِي كَانَ يَقُولْ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمُ كُلُّهُ لِطَلْحَ. He said, Abu Bakr says, if somebody mentioned the day of Uhud, I say that day was totally for Talha. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said about Talha, he is a murderer walking on earth. Shaheedun yamshi ala al-ard. Whoever wants to see a murder walking on earth, look at Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiallahu anhu. Okay. I'm done today.
Wow.
Yeah? What's that? With the command? We all done today. Any questions? Allah khaliq. Allahumma nida'an fa'amina.
How shiqami adar?
ابن قمي هو سأل كم شو أنا كاتب ولا مش كاتب. I don't know.
Very bad way.
والله I don't know. Then tell us.
Yes. ابن قمي, he was a shepherd. This guy, he used to have a lot of sheep. And the Rasulullah Sallam, he fell down in a ditch. Every time yes. he used to try to stand, ابن قمي used to hit him on his head
yeah.
with the sword too many times. Until like what the doctor said, the maghfar and this subhanAllah came to check for Rasulullah.
So.
The blood and everything. Rasulullah was about to die because of this.
Oh yeah, I know.
Yeah, he hits him badly on his head. And subhanAllah, after battle of Uhud, one time he was above the mountain with his sheep, Ibn Qamiha, حيوانة. So what happened, subhanAllah, one of the big sheep of his, subhanAllah, when he was standing above the, subhanAllah, close to the edge of the mountain, he hits him like this. He throwed him, he was falling from above the mountain, subhanAllah. Because he hits Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look how he died. Yeah.
He deserved it.
Yeah, subhanAllah. It's the way. But doctor, too many lessons from Ghazwat Uhud.
Yes.
Yeah, the main one, subhanAllah, Sahaba, Rasulullah, he was there. And they've been defeated because they did not listen to his orders.
That's a major lesson.
Yes.
When I'm finishing it, I'm gonna summarize what we learned from.
Yeah. And Nasiba bint Ka'ab, Umm Amara, that lady, she has a hair. She's one of those who get glad tidings of Jannah during her life. And they are not just only 10. Rasulullah he mentioned just only 10 Sahaba in one hadith. But people, they said that amongst the 10. But actually, we have more than 35 people. From the Sahaba and people before, like Sina Maryam and Asya, the wife of Faraon, and Khadija and Fatima. And too many hadiths, if you collected like more than 35 people, they get glad tidings of Jannah during their life. Yes. One of them, Nasiba bint Ka'b, Umm Amara. One of them, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, of course.
Yes.
And also, Mubarak Umm Ayman. Yes, subhanAllah.
Yes.
These people, they've been, subhanAllah, Rasulullah giving them glad tidings of Jannah during their life.
They heard it during their life.
Yeah. Fanasiba bint Ka'b, Umm Amara, that lady, she was the first nurse in Islam. Somebody ask you, who is the first nurse in Islam, that lady?
That's, she was curing the
yes, those who've been injured or something. This is her job. She was going for this.
Registered in, registered nurse.
And subhanallah, she turned to be a big fighter.
Yes.
Yes, subhanallah. She defended Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم during the battle of Ahad, he was asking the people to stand up. During the battle of Ahad, he asking the people to stand in front of them, in front of him, and he say, استو حتى أثني على ربي عز وجل. He's gonna supplicate to Allah. So استو, as if let's imagine. Yeah. That you know we are standing and we're supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min sharri ma a'taytana wa sharri ma mana'tana Allahumma habbib ilayna al-iman wa zayyinhu fi qulubina wa karrih ilayna al-kufr wal-fusuq wal-asiyan wa ja'alna min al-rashidin. That's kalam Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay. Dua. اللهم توفنا مسلمين وحينا مسلمين والحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين. اللهم قاتل الكفر الذين يكذبون رسلك ويصدون عن سبيلك واجعل عليهم رجزك وعذابك. اللهم قاتل الكفر. اللهم اكفنا شر العدا ونقهم الردى واجعلهم لكل حبيب فدا وسلط عليهم عاجل النقمة في اليوم والفدا. اللهم بدد شملهم وفرق جمعهم وقلل عددهم واجعل الدائرة عليهم وارسل العذاب الأليم إليهم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Seeds all dua against the kafara, against the mushrikeen, and that's what he was. That's one of his adaya during Ghazwat Uhud. Thank you very much.
Thank you.